Hello everyone, this is Stephanie. Welcome to another video. So today we're going to do the Summer Days Necklace. And the Summer Days Necklace is a continuation of the Summer Days and the Dizzy Daisy duo series that we've been working on. So we recently did these earrings, the Summer Days earrings, and I just thought this necklace would look really pretty with it. So this is what we're going to work on today. And I will put links to all the other Daisy jewelry that we've been making in case you want to take a look at those. So I'll put a link up for that. And I'll put a link in the description box as well, or links in the description box. All right, so why don't we take a look at this real quick. So here are the earrings, of course. I'll put those aside. Here's the necklace. And it's the same component. And we've got these, actually, if you just cover the rest of it, here's the earring right there. But we've changed a little bit. We've graduated the components, and I've used a combination of mini duos and super duos to give it this sort of nice graduated look. And the clasp is a toggle and loop, and it's a three ring toggle so that it's adjustable. So this gives me, you know, a couple more inches. This necklace is 18 inches, and then I get a couple more out of the clasp. I've ended it with the little wire protector that I embellished with these little 11-0 seed beads, and it turns out really nice. So why don't we get a materials list going, and we'll get started on this necklace. All right. So I was going to make it with the in this combination, but I didn't get my beads in time. So I'm going to change, it's going to be close, I'm just going to change it up to copper minis and super duos and black on the edges, so it'll be similar to this. All right, so you need some mini duos. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you the beads you're going to need, but I'm going to put the amounts in the description box. It's just easier to write everything in the description box, and that way you can look down there, and there's lots of interesting stuff down there at times. So I want you to look down there, and it's just easier to write it all down there. But you'll need some mini duos. Okay, you're going to need some super duos. I'm using the same color. You can change the colors if you want. You know, you can use minis to where you put the super duos on and then change the color. Why not? You're going to need some seed beads, and these are 11-0s. You're going to need some pearls. These are 4 millimeter pearls. I'm using black pearls here. So this is copper, metallic copper, black seed beads, black pearls. You're going to need some Miyuki drops, and these are 3.4 millimeter drops, and they're black. You're going to need some findings. So you'll need a clasp. I'm just using a ball and socket clasp here because I didn't have a three ring copper clasp, so I had this one, and I thought I'd just use this one. So that's the ball and socket. You'll need little wire protectors. These are a little small. The only copper ones I had were in the 4 millimeter or 4.5, get the 5 millimeter if you can. It's just a better fit. It's a little thicker, so 5 or even bigger. I don't know if they make them in 7. So you can, that. Then you need some jump rings, and these are I think a little big. These I think might be 12 millimeter. I would go down to 8 or 6. You don't need that big a jump ring. I just didn't have any. All right. You need a little stop bead. There. You need a size 11 beading needle. There you go. And I think for this one, 6-pound Fireline works really well because we're going to go through these beads a lot. So I would do a 6-pound Fireline on this. All right, so that's what you're going to need. Anything I forgot, I will put in the description box below the video. So why don't you gather up your materials and we'll get started making the Summer Days necklace. All right, see you in a few. We're back, and before we get started, I wanted to talk about the construction of this necklace a little bit and give you some numbers so you can make the length that you want. So the way we're going to construct this is we're going to do it from one end all the way to the other end. We're going to do this line of daisy units, and what they are is a daisy with a connector in between each one. And then after we're done with that, that's when we're going to add these drops on. That I find is the best way to make this. You can construct it all in one piece if you're a little more experienced beader. I find that it works out much better doing, and it's much more fluid doing this for this line of daisies first and then adding the bottom units on. You have to be very careful about your curve if you're going to do it, you know, make a full unit, then add a, a daisy and then a full unit so that, you know, it will curve on its own and it will be a curvy necklace to start with. This way it's straight and it just conforms really nice to the neck and it's very fluid. So we're going to do it this way. All right, so I'm going to give you some numbers now. If you want them, I'm going to make an 18-inch necklace. I have a 2-inch adjustable toggle, so I can go up to 20 inches on this. I find the 18 fits perfectly for me, but, you know, see, you'll have to see which necklace, you know which you like. So for an 18-inch necklace, get your pencils ready if you want these numbers. You're going to need 37 in total of these little daisy units right here. So we're not even talking about these right now. We're just preparing to put those on. So you need 37 of these all together. The first 12 are going to be plain units with no bottom connectors. So the first 12 are going to be plain, and then daisy 13 through daisy 25 are going to alternate with a bottom connector, no bottom connector. Bottom connector, no bottom connector. So this will always be the same. The only thing that's really going to change for length are going to be the ends. So beads, daisies 13 through 25, you're going to alternate, and then daisies 26 through 37 are going to be plain with no bottom connector. Okay, so that's for an 18-inch necklace. I just did a 16. So let's do the 16 too. So for a 16-inch necklace, you're going to have 33. Complete units. The first 10, daisies 1 through 10, are going to be plain with no bottom connector. 11 through 23 are going to have the alternating bottom connector and no connector. And then daisies 24 through 33 are going to be plain. Okay, for a 20-inch necklace, you're going to need 41 units. Daisies 1 through 14 are plain, no bottom connector. Daisies 15 through 27 are going to have the alternating connections right here. And then daisies 28 through 41 are going to be the plain daisy with no bottom connector. Okay, and I'm going to give you a 22-inch and then we're going to get started. Okay, so for a 22-inch necklace, you're going to use 45 units. The 1 through 16 are going to be plain, no bottom connector. 17 through 29 are going to have the alternating connectors. Daisies 30 through 45 are going to be plain, no bottom connector. All right, so there are your numbers. I'm going to put them in the description box also. There's going to be a lot in the description box. I'll put them there also, but in just in case you wanted them. The numbers, there they are. Okay, so if you want to write everything down, go ahead and then meet me back here. We're going to do the 18-inch necklace. So meet me back here in a few minutes and we'll get started. Okay, we're back. So I'm going to start with this end of the necklace. So we're going to work this way. So thread your needle with as much fire line as you can handle comfortably, because you want to have fun with this. You don't want to be all tangled up. Leave a 12 to 14-inch tail if you want to use the tail to sew on this clasp, but if you want to add the clasp separately, just leave enough to sew in 6 to 8 inches or so. String on 10 minis. Let's make those into a circle. So bring your thread around and sew up the first couple of beads you put on. Just makes it into a circle. And then just sew all the way around past where your tail thread is, just to reinforce. First one's always a little clumsy. Just keep sewing around. Just want to close that up. All right, so here I am. So I'm coming out of the bead that my tail thread is coming out of. It doesn't really matter at this point where you come out. The first one, setting the first one up, is just, you have to pay attention. But you really can put the first connector, and I'll show you that, anywhere. But I'm just going to use the tail thread as sort of a reference point. So this, I'm going to be working this way. So first thing we want to do is we want to get the purl on. Let's pick up a purl. And a good way to figure out where a purl goes, if you want to eyeball it, is just let it drop down, and it will. You want to connect it to the other side, and it will kind of go there on its own. If you want to count, you can count. So I'll count from where my tail thread is coming out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's see, how does 5 look? 5 looks pretty good to me. So I'm going to sew, or even 6. I'm going to sew up through, actually, bead number 6. The bottom hole, going up this way. Okay. And that should place my purl on pretty much in the center. And it sort of secures it. So now come all the way around your beads. Just keep sewing through. We're still through the bottom hole. So we want to sew all the way around until we're on the other side of the unit, directly across from where your tail thread is coming out, because that's where we're going to add our connector. So keep sewing around. Come around pretty much to that side. So let's count the beads so we can get the connector on. So one, so here's my tail thread and my stop bead. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Actually, I'm coming up through the bottom, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm gonna go up one more. Just like that, and I'm going to come down the top hole of that bead. Just like that. Then I'm going to pick up a mini, and I'm going to add my side connector. And that sort of situates it directly across from where the stop bead is. If you didn't get there, and it's some, you know, you've got it, the connector somewhere else, it's fine for the first one, because the connectors that are really going to matter are the subsequent connectors. You want them always directly across from the previous connector. So don't worry about it if it's not perfect like this. Just make sure you get a connector on. Okay, then add a seed bead between every mini all the way around. Keep coming around. So I'm putting on my last seed bead. So I'm going to come through the top hole of the next mini plus that first hole of the connector. Just like that. And then to complete the unit, I'm going to come up through the second hole of the connector. And make sure you always complete that unit, because you might forget to come up through the second hole before you add your next connector, and then it won't go on correctly. The beads won't go on correctly. So there you have it. You have your first daisy. So this is where we're going. We're gonna connect daisies from there. All right. So pick up 10 of your minis. 5, 6, 7. Check your holes and check your amount. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You're coming out of the top hole of this connector. Just come through the bottom and place on another unit. So all the way around your unit, to reinforce. All the way around and past the command of the connector bead, just like that. Now, at this point, you can add your next purl. So just to show you, because I love to change things up periodically, I'm working on this one, and instead of putting a purl in every daisy, I'm going to alternate them. Just kind of like the way it looks. It's open for the summer. So here, we're doing exactly this, only I'm just not going to put a purl in. I'm going to put a purl in every other one. So you're going to start out the first one with a purl, and then the next one is going to be open, next one's a purl, next one is open, and I'm going to do that all the way down. And it's just going to give it a little openness just for a change. I thought that'd be kind of cool. But you can just put the purl in just like we did previously. All right? So I'm not going to do that. So I'm just going to keep coming around, so put your purl on, like I said, if you want to put your purl on, and then just keep coming around, secure your purl like you did before, keep coming around, just like that, and now you want to put on another connector. So we're at the point now, let's say I have my purl on and I put my connector on. Now this one, you have to make sure this connector is directly across from the other one. So I'm coming around the top. I came around the top, so count. Don't count the connector, just count after the connector. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is bead number 6. I'm going to come back up. Coming out of bead number 6, I'm going back up bead number 6. I'm going to add my connector. And that's going to place it directly across from the other one. So then pick up a seed bead and put a seed bead in between each mini. Now I'm going to change it up a little bit when you get to the connector, because we're not going to add a seed bead between the mini before the connector and the connector at this point, because you don't need it. So right here, instead of adding a seed bead there, I'm just going to go right through the connector. And if you did any of the Dizzy Daisy Duo pieces, this is how we did it. It just gives it a nice movement there. It gives it some movement, and it really holds it together. You don't really see any thread. And so we're going to come through the one after the connector also, and see how it kind of holds it together. So you don't really need that seed bead there. So just come around with all your seed beads. Come through the top hole of that last mini. And don't forget to complete your unit by coming down the second hole of the, so you're coming out of the top hole of the connector, go down the second one, just so that completes the unit. So now I have two units on. Now if you're doing it with the purls, you'll just have two units on that are purls. So continue doing this. So, you know, you're depending on your length, it's going to depend on how many of these daisies, plain daisies, you're going to add until you get to the daisy with the daisy with the bottom connector. Okay, so go on and do that, and meet me back here after you have your number on, and then we'll start putting on daisies with bottom connectors. All right, see you in a few. Have fun. Okay, we're back, and I hope you had fun making your first series of daisies. So I'm making a mini necklace because I want to get this video up, and I want to get it all done quickly. So here I am. Let's say I'm doing my 18-inch necklace, so I'm on daisy. I've done 12 daisies. Okay, so this is where I would be right here. So I'm working. This is daisy number 13. So this is where I'm going to add my first bottom connector. So this next daisy is going to have a bottom connector and a side connector and a purl. So put on your 10 minis, make it circle, come around just like we've done before. Everything is just normal up to this point. Put on your, you know, we're going to come around. Just like that. Till we get to the connector, so come through the connector. All right. Let's add the purl on. Just like that. Sometimes it will go in a different place, but just make sure you're sewing up through either, I think it's either bead 5 or 6 to get your purl on. Probably you're an expert at that by now because you've done so many. So come around. Come around. Doing a lot of reinforcing here, but that's all right. It's really good for the piece. So I want you, so you're going to put your bottom connector on here, but the one I want you to put on first is the side connector. Always put your side connector on first. Just the sequence works out better that way. Okay, so I'm getting ready to put on my side connector. I've come all the way around. Okay, so I'm going to count my one. So let's say, did I come through the top? Came through the bottom. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to go up to bead number 6. And then I'm going to come down the first, you know, the outer hole of bead of mini duo number 6. I'm going to put on my connector. Just like that. Okay, so this one is going to go right there. See? All right, so now put on a seed bead. Put on another seed bead. Put on your next connector. So you have two seed beads and then a connector. Then we're going to add another seed bead right here. And where before we didn't add any seed beads on either side of the connector, I like to add a seed bead, one seed bead right here. And the reason I do that is because then you have, then it's even on the bottom. You see, so you have two seed beads on this side and two seed beads on that side. You don't have to do it on the top, so just come through the next mini and then add your 4 seed beads. So that's 1. Just makes it more symmetrical. 2, 3, 4. Come through the bottom hole of the connector. And then to complete your unit, come through the top hole of the connector. Now you have your first connector, bottom connector bead on of your necklace. So it's going to go right here. And this is preparing for when you add on your bottom. Okay? All right. So now the next connector is just a plain one without a bottom. Now you can put it on with the purl or without. I'm doing it without because I'm alternating, but you can just put another purl one on. And then you're going to do your next one with the bottom connector and the side connector, so you're just going to alternate. All right, so put on a plain one with just the side connector, and then the next one is going to have the side connector and the bottom connector. And you're going to do that, so just ignore these guys right now. You're going to do that for your 18-inch necklace. We're going to do that with starting on daisy 13. I just want to look and make sure. Starting on daisy 13 through, so that's 13, 14, 15. Here, I'm going to pull out just to give you a reference. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. So you're going to do this whole center portion, alternating bottom connector, no bottom connector, bottom connector, no bottom connector, bottom connector, no bottom connector, and so on until you get your last bottom connector on bead 25. And then you're going to do beads 26 through 37, no bottom connector. Okay, so you have a lot of work to do. I'll check back periodically to see how you're doing. And I'll be working on mine, my center part also. All right, so have fun. Just rewind as you need to. It's going to be gorgeous. I'm really liking these the alternate open and purl. So I'll check back once in a while, and I'll see you soon. All right, have fun. Okay, I'm back for a minute. Just checking up, seeing how you're doing. So I've gotten all my bottom connectors on. So here I'll show you. So let's say this is my necklace up to the connector. So here's my first bottom connector. So I have a bottom connector, a regular one without the bottom, and then I've alternated them, and I end up with 7 connectors. And here I'll just pop it on this one, so you can see that all 7 connectors are going to connect the bottom, these bottom units here. All right. So that's exactly what you should have, just like that. But I see at this point I've run out of thread, or I'm running out of thread. So I'm going to add some thread, and I'm going to show you how. Let's come in a little bit. I threaded a needle with the amount of thread I want to add on, and I put on a stop bead, and I've left a tail, enough tail to sew in. So the thing about adding thread is wherever your, this guy, wherever your tail, your working thread is coming out of, the one that you're adding to, you just want your thread to come out of that same place. So you want to snake your way through the beads until your thread is coming out, your new thread is coming out of here. So I'm just going to come back through some of my beads, and what happens is the stop bead holds that in place, so that's not going to move, and I can sew that in later, or I can do it whenever. Don't clip off the old thread yet, because sometimes you think, okay, I remember where I clipped it off, and then you don't remember where you clipped it off, and you end up putting things on your new thread on in the wrong direction. Just a very easy mistake to make. Okay, so just leave that thread on until you get your new thread on. So just come through the beads, and your goal is just to get to that spot where your old thread is coming out. So here we go, going up. Now I'm exactly where my old thread is coming out. Now at this point, I can kind of take my old thread and come back through, you know, through this bead. I can and then I'll come down. Just to move it out of the way, I'll come down some beads on the side. And at this point, you can tie some knots to get that thread out of the way. So here, I'll tie a half-inch knot right there. Make a loop, come through. And I'll pop through another bead. And then I'll leave it right there and clip that off. I don't want to go through the connector too much. I just want to just sew that thread in. So that thread is sewn in. Then you're going to do it with the top thread. You can wait till later. It's got a stop bead on there. It's not going anywhere. And now you can just start adding on more units. So now I'm just going to continue adding on just plain units here. And then we'll come back and we'll start adding those cool graduated drops on the bottom. All right, see you in a few. Okay, we're back. And I've finished my piece. So I've done my sort of mini necklace. And so I have, so this is the center portion right here. We have 7 of these bottom drops, okay, for these 7 drops. So count in 3 of the drops, number 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's where you're going to put your first drop. Don't mess up and put it somewhere else, it won't come out good. All right, so this is the drop we're going to work on. So put on your thread a seed bead and a mini. Let me move everybody up a little bit. Seed bead and a mini, and so you have 6 minis on, and you have 6 seed beads on. So you've started with an 11-0, and you're ending with a mini. then add an 11-0, a super duo, 11-0, super duo, 11-0, super duo. So add that on, and then add an 11-0 and a mini, and do that again just like your first one, six, so until you have six minis on, and then add an extra seed bead. Okay? So this is what you have. I'll just hold it there for a second. Okay, so bring those down to your stop bead. I don't know if I said you'd put on a couple of feet of fire line and a stop bead. Leave a little tail. Count in again and make sure you're on number four. One, two, three. And this is four. Okay, one, two, three, here's four. Come through the connector on the bottom hold of the connector, just like that. And pull on those beads. Now just sew up from the tail through all your beads. You won't get them all at once to make it into a circle. Let's give it a pull. And it should pull on just like that. And then just continue around to where the connector is. So just come around. Come around. Just like that, come through the last few and the bottom hole of the connector, just like that, give it a pull, this is what you have. Come back through the top hole of the connector, so you're reversing direction, and give that a pull, this is what you have. Okay. Pick up an 11-0. Come through the top hole of the first mini. Just like that. Then pick up a mini. Put one mini duo between the next several mini duos until you have five minis on. So I have one, two, three, four, five. Okay, now pick up a super duo, put on one super duo through each top hole of the next, got a little seed bead stuck there. So until you have, you're gonna put on four of your super duos. That's two, four. See if I can clean up the decks a little bit here. And then after you have your four super duos on, continue adding minis until you get to the end. Two. That's three. is what you have. I'm just going to move my stop bead a little bit. Just so you can see it better. Here we go. Pick up an 11-0. And go through the top hole of the connector. Just like that. And now you are fully connected onto your piece. Now I think I just have my... Actually, I'm good. So now what I want you to do is I want you to come around. So you're coming through the top hole of the connector, come through the 11-0 and the mini duo, and then come all the way around your piece. So we're going to reinforce here. So just work your way all the way around. And at this point, if you want it to curve inward, give it a pull. If not, just, you know, flatten it out and keep your tension a little bit more loose. So just come around reinforcing this whole area here, just like this, okay? And then meet me when you get to the end here, and we'll work on the next round. Okay, see in a few. Okay, so I've come around, and I've reinforced everybody, so I'm just going to work my way back up here a little bit, just like this, coming through the last bead, okay? And then what I'm going to do here is I'm going to come back down through this, I'm coming out of this, the top of this mini. I'm going to come down through, just a few minis. I'm doing this to reverse direction. So I'm coming out of one of these, let's say this one. Come back up through to this one at the top. See that? And then down through the top hole of that mini. And now we're going to add the drops. And if it's a little loose, don't worry about it. I haven't sewn in my tail thread yet. You'll get your tail thread in there and it'll tighten everybody up. You can really tie in the tail thread at any time. I'm just leaving it for the moment. Okay. So, here we are. We're coming out of this mini duo, the top mini duo right here. Get out your drops and your 11-0s. So pick up an 11-0 and a drop, come through the next mini, just like that. An 11-0 and a drop, through the next mini, 11-0 and a drop. And try to pick out the drops that are most even at the top, the same width, because sometimes these drops are really uneven at the top, so it can pull your beads apart a little bit. So just for spacing purposes, just try to just get some uniform ones. So an 11-0 on a drop, and then when you come through the super duos, because it's a bigger space here, just the super duos, pick up an 11-0, a drop, and an 11-0. So you're adding the extra 11-0 because you have that extra space in there. Just like that. And then come all the way around. 11-0, drop, 11-0. And only put the two 11-0s on like this, just in between the super duos. When you come to the end here where you have a super duo and there's a mini next to it, just put one 11-0 and a drop. So you're going to end up at the bottom with three drops that have 11-0s on either side, and then you're going back to just one 11-0 and a drop, just like that. And just finish that, come all the way to the top, and then meet me back here, and we'll tie it off, and then you can do the rest of them. All right, seen a few. Okay, I've come to the end of the row. And I'm just going to just come back. So I'm coming out of this. I've put my last drop on and I'm coming out of the top of this mini. So then just go back that many and reinforce your way around here. You have a lot of thread already coming through these, so let's come around. Tie some half hitch knots here. I've curved mine. It's kind of cool. It gets sort of round when you curve it, so I kind of like the dimension of it. So just come around, tie some half hitch knots, take off your stop bead and your tail thread, and just sew your tail thread in around also. I don't think you need me to do that. You can do that. And then tie some half hitch knots and meet me back here, and we'll talk about the next one. Okay, see you in a minute. I've come back for a second just because I just want to make sure you're getting your tail thread in nice. So here's my tail thread. It's coming out of this seed bead. So I'm just going to work my way around and see how that straightens everybody out. So just come down around the inside of your piece here. Tie a half hitch knot. I'm not going to do that, but tie some half hitch knots, and then you'll have a nice little drop. So that's very cool, huh? All right, so let's talk about the next one. So with this one, you put on 6 of your minis, okay, with seed beads in between, right? So at the next, okay, so you put on 6. So the next one, and we're going to go this way, and then you can add the other 3 on. So the next one, you're going to start with 5 minis, okay? So you're going to take 5 minis, and here I'll show you on this one, all right? So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 minis, and then the number of super duos doesn't change. The only thing that changes is the number of minis that you're putting on to make this unit a little smaller. So you're going to go from 6 to 5 to 4 to 3. Okay, so when you put on, so originally when we put 6 mini duos on the original circle here, and then we came around, then you add 1 mini duo in between each mini for the second round. So you have 6, and then you're adding 5 in between. Okay, so this one you're going to add 5 on your original round, and then you're just going to have 4 before you start the super duos. And the super duos are the same, 3 on the first round and then 4 on the next round. And then you have 4 on the next drop, and then there are 3 minis, okay? And then you're doing the same thing on the other side, and then you have 3. You're in your original, the same 3 super duos here and the same 4 on the bottom, and then there'll just be 2 before you get to your super duo here. So you're just reducing the number of beads that you put in your first round by 1, which will automatically reduce the number that will go around on the second round. Okay, so I think you could probably figure that out. So why don't you go ahead and get those done. So you're going to do 6, 5, 4, and 3. 6, 5, 4, and 3. Okay, and then meet me back here and we'll put on the clasp. All right, see you in a few. You're back, and I have put on just 1 more of my sort of drop pieces here. And I just, of course, have the other 2 to go, but I just wanted to get the video done. So let's, before we put the clasp on, I just want to make sure that you're okay with the rest of the drops here. So in case you need a visual, I think you're going to be fine, but in case you need a visual and you really want to look at it, I'm going to pull in right here, and you can, if you want, you can pause the video right here and you can just look at these as a guide. But I think this, doing that one kind of really showed you how to do it for the rest of them. All right, so I'm going to pull out a little bit now, okay? And we're going to put the clasp on. So both your ends should look like this. Now, if you did what I did and you put an extra mini duo on at one end, just take it off. I probably should have told you not to put one on at that end, but I just kept going 2. So if you did, just take it off and put an 11-0 where that mini duo was. So I'm going to put my clasp on separately. All right. So I've got my needle, and I put on about a foot of fire line, and I'm just gonna I want my thread to come out of the mini that's directly across from the connector mini right there. Pulling a teeth it. I don't want to go crazy here. Okay. So I'm just gonna, I put the stopping on and the foot of fire line, and I'm just gonna start back here. Just like this. And I'm gonna just sew through my beads on the outside until I get to this mini duo. That's the one directly across from the one from the connector. Just gonna come through just like that. I'm gonna pick up an 11-0 and my wire guardian, which I switched the copper one out to a 5mm silver, only because the size is better, and I want you to see how it looks with the 5mm one, because it's a better fit, I think, for this. And that one, I think, was 4. So just put on a seed bead, and you come through the side channel of your wire protector, pick up 7 11-0s, like that. Come down the other side of your wire protector so that these 7 beads sit in the channel, just like that. Then pick up an 11-0 and come through the other side of that mini duo. Just like that. When you pull, it should straighten everyone out, just like that. Now reinforce by coming up through the 11-0 and the channel, then come through all of these 11-0s around the wire guardian and down the other channel on the other side and through the mini duo again. Through, let's see, to make sure I got through the seed bead, come through the seed bead first, and then the other side of the mini right there, just to connect them, just like that. And that's exactly how it should look. Now, if you can get through again, go through again, but if not, just come around and reinforce. So this is how it should look. And you're just going to tie some half hitch knots around. So here I'll tie one. Come through your mini. Well, I'll just let you come through your mini. I'm not going to fight with it right now. Okay, so that's how it looks. All right. And then, of course, take off your stop bead and sew your the tail in. And that's it. I mean, we're done. So that's how it's going to work. Oh, and we want to actually put the clasp on. Okay, don't want to forget the clasp. All right. So we have the wire guardian on. So just take your jump ring, and don't want to forget that. Open it up. Put on one half of your clasp, come through the wire guardian, and it's very hard to show you this on when the camera's at this angle, but then just close up your jump ring. That's, of course, this is a huge jump ring, and this is way too big, but you get the idea. So that's how that's going to look. And then just do the same thing to the other end, all right? So let's take a look at the finished necklace. Okay, so here it is. Here are the earrings. Like that. I just thought I'd pull out the bracelet. Now this bracelet, I borrowed the rondelles because I needed them for another project, which is a good argument for putting the clasp on separately. Not that I would suggest you borrow pieces off your jewelry. It's just that this is a, you know, this was a video piece. So I often just take them apart or, you know, pieces of them and borrow pieces of them. But I just wanted to show you the bracelet. So here's the bracelet. And then I had one other idea that I wanted to share with you. So I picked up a couple of these pearls. What do you think? I love that. So you really could incorporate a pearl in there. And why not even put... So these are those pear pearls that I used on Crazy for Pearls. Okay. And if it doesn't fit here, why not? We can just put it... You can just put a little 6mm pearl. But how cool is that? I love the earrings. And so it's just another look. So if you want to, you know, change things up, you can always add some drops while you're doing it. So a lot you can do with it. All right, so I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you make it this and have fun with it. It really is a lot of fun, and I love it for summer. I'm really looking forward to summer coming, so be nice to have some sort of light and sort of airy jewelry, and maybe not so many crystals at the moment. Yeah, so of course we always have crystals. All right, so thank you for joining me, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care, bye-bye.